I'm Pittsburgh's chief meteorologist, Stephen Cropper. Whether you're a student or you've long graduated, there's always time in your day to learn. And the folks at the Carnegie Science Center are helping us do that. They put together some really cool videos for us here at Channel 11 to share with you.
Let's explore together a little bit of outdoor science and zoology by making snacks for some of our small animal friends. Now, let's think about a bird flying in the air or sitting on a tree branch outside of our homes. What do you think they might need to eat? Well, different birds like to eat different things, like fruit, seeds, insects, snails, tree sap, flower nectar, sometimes even fish, snakes, and smaller birds. Today, we are making a bird feeder snack for our smaller bird friends. In my backyard, I see a lot of small birds like robins, mourning doves, and even sparrows. And to make your own homemade bird feeder today, we're gonna need a few different supplies. Here I have some pine cones, a little bit of shortening, some bird seed, which has some sunflower seeds, cracked corn, and safflower seeds. I also have some dried berries, a set of scissors, some string, and a spatula. But you can use whatever reusable utensil you'd like to help spread your ingredients all around your pine cone. Now, the first thing that you'll need to do in order to make your pine cone bird feeder is actually cut some string. So I like to measure my string to be about a grown-up's arm length, or a little bit over a foot. Now I've already cut my string and tied it to my pine cone here. I tied a little knot around the top of my pine cone, as well as a little hoop so I could hang it from a tree branch. Now the first thing that you're gonna have to do in order to make your pine cone bird feeder is cover it with a little bit of shortening. So I have some shortening here that I'm going to spread all over my pine cone. Now, pine cones have things on them called scales that are easy for birds to hold onto and for us to pack our seeds and our bird mix into. Now, I collected my pine cones from my trees outside. They come from pine trees. And pine cones help to hold the seeds of the pine trees. So by spreading the shortening all around my pine cone and on my pine cone scales, it allows it to be sticky. And that's going to help all of my bird seed to stay onto my pine cone. Now you want to pack it in nice and tight so it's able to all stick together. This part can be a little messy, but that's totally fine, and that's half the fun. Now today I'm using shortening to help all of my ingredients stick to my pine cone, but you can use other fatty things to stick to your pine cone. You can use peanut butter, lard, or even bacon fat. But these really sticky substances have a lot of fat in them, which is actually good for our birds because it allows our birds to store fat for later on in the colder months. Now the next thing I'm going to do is add a few pieces of dried cranberries onto my bird feeder here. Voila! And now you have a bird feeder that you can hang in your backyard. By observing the different birds that come to visit your bird feeder, you will find out what types of species live around you. Try and see how many different types of birds that you can spot in your backyard. Now the next time you come to the Science Center, look for our friends in red doing fun experiments like this one out on our exhibit gallery floors, or join us in our live demonstration theaters. For more fun science videos to watch, log on to carnegiesciencecenter.org for things to watch, things to read, and things to do at home. Thank you for watching, and we hope to see you soon at Carnegie Science Center.